Hello everyone and welcome to week 5 of my film music writing course. Lovely to welcome you all back and hope you've had a lovely week of writing some scary intense music from last week. So today we are going to be looking at comedy and how to write comedy in music, and also looking at musical expression, how we can really sort of bring our pieces to life through many different types of expressions in music. So a theme that crops up in music a lot is comedy, and it's one of the hardest moods to create in music. So like I said, we're also going to look at musical expressions and how we can bring the music to life through articulations, dynamics, tempo markings and ornaments or ornamentations. So if we look over to our left, we can actually just have a little talk about some of those because they're quite big words. So we can sort of break it down and recap on some stuff that you already might know. So our legato and staccato are our articulations. Our legato is joining the notes together, and the staccato is the detachment of notes. So they're very short and spiky and quick. So dynamics is where the music is either loud or quiet. Okay, so we've got many different types of dynamics. You've got PP, so pianissimo, where it's very, very quiet. You've got P, MF, mezzo forte, forte F, and then fortissimo F. You can go to the very extremes at both ends. Okay, and dynamics really helps to shape and the character and the mood of the piece through this ebb and flow of sound. Okay, and we've got tempo markings, which we haven't talked too much about, and tempo markings is basically the expression of how you want the performer to perform your music, and also the speed as well. You may see this through notes, so you might have crotchet equals 116, or you can have it in word form as well. So sometimes you might have an Italian, French or German expression marking that tells you how you want to perform it. So as an example here, con fuoco, with fire, with fierceness, okay, in the music, and that gives you an idea that when you want to perform the music, you want to perform it with some fierce and sort of menace behind it. So that's our tempo markings. And then our ornaments or ornamentation that we're going to talk about today, especially in comedy music, is stuff like trills or little tiny grace notes here. So little tiny notes like this, which I'm going to talk about in a sec. So all those things we're going to cover today in comedy music and expressions in music. Okay. So as an example of how we could use this in a theme is, you can see down here is I've got my harmony, which we looked at a primary chord, and the use of a D minor chord, chord 2 in C major underneath. And I've got my superhero theme on top, but I'm now going to put it into a comedy setting using my articulations, dynamics, tempo markings and ornaments to really bring the piece out. So looking at the start, I've got scherzando, which is to play with playfulness and lightness to the music. So already that really sets us up with how we want to play the music. Now I've got some dynamics in here. I'm starting off loud, going down quiet and ending loud. And I've got some ornaments. I've got a trill here in the middle, and a trill is where you go between two notes very, very quickly, okay? And this is heard a lot in comedy music. And I've also got my grace note, which you can see at the end, where I'm going between an F sharp and a G very quickly. So a grace note is going between two notes, but very, very quickly. And you've got to squeeze it in, okay? So I'm just going to play this out so you can hear how I can really start to mould my superhero theme, which was quite sort of calm before, into something which is quite playful and bouncy. Okay? So you can start to see how all those trills and ornaments really sort of bring out all these fireworks and playfulness to the music, and especially the use of the staccato in that left hand, okay? In the bar two, I didn't play it very well, is I've actually sustained the F major chord down, and then I've got a staccato after, so in that left hand I've got... which creates a really nice playful bounciness underneath the already colourful melody. Okay. So try this out. Try out all these different things, your articulations, your dynamics, your tempo markings and your ornaments with your already existing melody or with another theme that you want to write as well, okay, for a different character. So some tips, tricks and examples, thinking about the broader context and going back to the themes that I've already covered over the last five few lessons. And we're just going to talk through each one. So I've got my superhero theme at the top, where I've got some moving rhythm underneath, which was one of my examples from a lesson a couple of weeks ago. So in this one here, think about the expressions. So all the things that we listed in the previous slide. I've got dynamics, which is going to bring out the shape of this melody underneath. I've got legato and staccato in that melody. Really start to bring contour and shape to its the way that it sort of leads, and then underneath I've got moving harmony, that's staccato, so I really want to put that into staccato. Okay, so it really creates this chugging, moving feel like the superhero sort of flying off. And creates a bit more playfulness and bounciness to it when you use staccato. And then a challenge for you guys as well, which you can start to think about, is putting accents in. So you can see here, above certain notes, you've got the tiny little crocodile mouth backwards, like the diminuendo, and that is an accent. So every time I play those notes, I'm gonna put a bit more weight behind it, a bit more oomph behind it, and it just pops out those notes. And something as well you might have noticed is this little line under this E here, it's a tenuto. So what that means is you're also going to put a bit more weight onto it, but it's not going to be short or it's not going to be legato, it's kind of in between. So you're going to put a bit more weight onto it. It's not staccato, it's not legato, but put a bit sort of emphasis onto it, but not so much like that accent. So I'm just going to play this this theme for you, so you can really start to think about all these different articulations, dynamics, and ornaments really sort of bring out the music. Okay, so going on to the second one, and actually looking at what we looked at last week, this is now my superhero theme, but I've changed it into C minor. Okay, into the minor, and it's in that scary, intense character that I sort of wanted to create with this theme. Okay, so you can see I've got really quiet dynamics. So we've got pianissimo, and it ends forte, so it's like a kind of a jump scare at the end. I've used legato and a bit of staccato as well in the melody with my tenuto, which I talked about, to really create that shape and that character in that melody. I've got static harmony underneath, so a bit opposite to what I've had in the theme above. I'm now having static harmony because I don't want anything too much going on, it being too lively, because it's meant to be an intense, very focused scene. Okay, so that was my decision for that. And then also on top of that, which can be a challenge for you guys as well, which we talked about last week, is adding in accidentals, so our sharps and flats at various moments to really create a really exotic sound world in that melody. As you can see, I've used that tritone from last week, going from the C to the F sharp, that devil interval, which creates already a clash between the harmony and the melody. So it kind of goes against what we've talked about, but that's good because we want it to sound like that. Okay, so I'm just going to play this to you to give you an idea. And as well, you'll notice you've got the octave mark above, so the melody will be a bit higher than usual. Okay. And then the third example, I've actually brought back the villain theme that I wrote, I think all the way back in week one, to give you an example of just a different key and a different melody. Okay, so you can see in this one here, I've used a variety of dynamics, just like the other ones. I've got my pianos, fortes, crescendos and diminuendos. I've got legato in the melody and also legato harmony underneath as well in that left hand. And remember as well, the harmony underneath, doesn't have to be a pianist. You can record the harmony and try out different expressions on your harmony. And this sort of creates a very mysterious lurking feeling that you'll hear in a minute. And that's what I was going for with my villain. And then also I've chosen to include some accidentals and sharps and flats here and there in the right hand. So I've chosen to put C sharp in to make it D harmonic minor with that sharpened seventh. And also thought about flattening that B for the Dorian mode. So that was the challenge weeks back. So there's loads of different components I've put into this villain theme, but I'll just give you an idea for the expressions I've put in, thinking about what I've put in terms of articulations and dynamics. So my character there was really sort of lurking in the undergrowth and being very menacing there. Now, something I want to talk about as well is on top of all of these, I've put my tempo markings, my expression markings at the top. So at the top with that one, it was quite fast and chugging. So I put allegro, which is fast, lively in Italian, okay? The next one I've put for my scary one is misterioso. So in Italian, it is mysterious, okay? And that's exactly how I want the performer to perform it, especially for a scary or intense theme. And then grave, is solemn and slow. So that's exactly what I wanted for that villain in the undergrowth. So remember, at the end, once you've written your theme, think about how you want the performer to perform it and how fast and slow you want it. Remembering that actually some of these words, allegro, means quick and fast, okay? So actually on top of it being how you want them to perform it, actually tell them how fast or how slow you want to perform it as well. So I hope that helps with some tips, tricks and examples with how you can put all these expression markings into the music. So now have a go at yourself. So there's a lot of things to be thinking about in this lesson because we've covered comedy and we've also covered expression markings to add to your various themes that you've been writing the last few weeks. So this stage now is very personal. So when you're adding dynamics, articulations, tempo markings and expression markings to your theme, remember there are no rules. So what sounds good to someone may not sound so good to another. So experiment through trial and error until you yourself are happy with how your music sounds. That is the most important thing, that you are happy with what you've written, okay? You can copy and paste your themes like I've talked about in previous weeks. So the last few weeks we've looked at adding different characteristics to your music. So by the end of this course, you're equipped with having different ways of creating various moods in film compositions. But like I've said, you don't have to always be rewriting material. You can use your same theme, but just copy and paste it for each lesson and be sort of moulding and just adjusting different bits to add to what we've been covering in the lesson, okay? Also, you don't need to write down your music. If you're confused how to write down your music, remember it isn't necessary to write it out in note form. I mentioned in previous weeks using recording apps such as Acapella to document your ideas, or even a phone recorder, or iMovie is a great one. Or you can think of other creative ways, like I've said, of writing down your music on paper as well. Especially when you're starting to bring in all these expressions and stuff, what's great if it's on paper is you can write out your melody, if it can be in colour or shape form or notes, in fact, and you can then start to label it as well with arrows, and that I want that note to be staccato, that note to be piano, okay? And then you can actually see a visual idea of it that's not in note form, but then after, see if you can give it a go, write it in note form, okay? So really, really good stuff. So we've kind of gone through those building blocks, and these last two lessons we've really started to really get into the nitty-gritty bits of being able to characterize your music through certain different ways of doing it, like we've covered today and last week in scary music and comedic writing as well. Next week we're now going to start looking about actually taking that process and putting it into film context and writing it to a film. So next week might be a bit more of an intense session, but you're nearly there. We've got one more to go, and this is where the magic starts to really happen. So well done. Have a lovely week, giving it a go, and I should see you next week. See you later.